But now, whenever you have online learning or you have online tools, you need to also think of the important areas where you have to engage your students, look into the side of the student, and what are the requirements for your students to have to be able to have a live interaction that is participative. So on the student side, therefore, you have to ensure that you have what you call devices, which could be laptops or smartphones or tablets. You have also maybe a computer. If they don't have smartphones, then they can have a computer. But most important is that you need to have an internet connection, which is high speed, in fact. Because to be able to run live sessions, you need a high-speed internet connection. So that is very important. But again, another aspect you have to look into is to make sure that you are orienting your students on how to access these resources, how to join an online meeting, how to respond to these live interactions, and how to make sure that they are gaining or learning some aspect of the particular lesson in the way they can be able to manage that. And then, if they are in their homes, therefore, and you are doing a live session from your own center, then it's good that you instruct the parents or the guardians or the people who are living with the children back in their homes to be able to help them, give them support, move them forward, and be able to allow them to be able to have a better learning experience from their homes as well. So that is one of the important aspects of online learning. So in the next preceding sessions, you'll be seeing a demonstration on how JITS or Google Hangout or Zoom is actually working in Tupress, where we really have activities to be able to do on applying these ways you can be able to learn in this aspect.